just what is tubular ligation in dogs? How does it relate to pyometra? And what is the benefit and the side effects of it, or the detrimental effects of it, compared to getting your dog spayed? Well, in this video, I'm going to discuss all this and more. Hi, I'm Dr. Alex from ourpetshealth.com, where my aim is to bring you pet health information all designed to help you and your dog to live a healthier, happier life. So make sure you're subscribed by clicking that button down below if you're not already. So in this episode, which is an episode of Dr. Alex Answers, I answer a question sent in by Alan, where he asked me all about kind of tubular ligation and how it related to pyometra and what the options were apart from getting your dog spayed in preventing future pyometras. So his background was that he has a dog who had a couple of litters. It didn't go kind of completely smoothly, and they decided they didn't want to breed from their dog again. And so after kind of discussing the different options, elected to have a tubular ligation performed. Now, once that was done, their female dog then came into heat again, was mated by their male dog, and then developed a nasty vaginal discharge and developed a pyometra. Now, thankfully, after a month's worth of antibiotics, their dog came right and was better again, but it was touch and go, and they were worried that they would, you know, Alan was worried that he would lose his dog. So it was, you know, pretty serious. And his question is, you know, why was that possible with that, having had the tubular ligation done? He was under the impression that that kind of really reduced the risk of a pyometra. And then what are the options going forward, given that his dog already has had a pyometra? So I just want to start off by saying, you know, by discussing what a tubular ligation surgery is. So what that is you've got the ovaries, and they then go down the fallopian tubes, the uterus to the uterine body, and obviously then to the cervix and the vagina and the outside world. Now, what a tubular ligation is basically the tubes either get tied, so they have a loop of suture material passed around the tubes and tied tight, so effectively kind of closing off the ability for the ovaries, for the eggs to kind of pass further down where they can then get inseminated. Or you can actually kind of tie it off and then make a wee incision between that, so there's absolutely no chance that the eggs could pass from the ovaries or the sperm could reach the eggs going up the other way. So that's really what a tubular ligation is. Now, how that differs from a spay, and a spay procedure refers to either an ovariohysterectomy or an ovariectomy. So you can refer to a spay with both of those procedures. Now, an ovariohysterectomy is removal of the ovaries and the uterus, and an ovariectomy is just the removal of both ovaries. Now, both of those procedures are obviously going to eliminate the risk of pregnancy from developing, but it also completely eliminates the risk of pyometra. And actually, tubular ligation has no effect on the likelihood of a dog to have a pyometra. The reason for that is, for a pyometra to occur, there needs to be something called a corpus luteum. So what happens with an ovary is the ovaries will develop these follicles, which they almost look like kind of blisters on top of the ovary, and the egg is within that follicle. That follicle will then rupture when a dog's on heat. The egg will be released and then will pass down the uterus, like I discussed, and a corpus luteum will form. And that corpus luteum is responsible for maintaining pregnancy. So if we don't have ovaries, so whether a dog's been spayed with an ovariohysterectomy or an ovariectomy, if we don't have ovaries, we can't have a corpus luteum, and so we can't get a pyometra develop. It just can't happen. Now, could there theoretically be other uterine infections? Well, I guess possibly they could kind of go up the other way. You could have a foreign body, so certainly something like a grass seed can get into the vulva and work its way up, and that can certainly happen, but it is very, very, very rare. So as far as I'm concerned, a spayed animal, as long as there's been no ovarian tissue left, and that's something that can happen very occasionally again, but as long as there's no ovarian tissue, pyometra is not a risk. with tubular ligation, the ovaries are still there. We've done nothing to the ovaries. And so a pyometra is just as likely. And so by the time a dog gets to 10 years of age, there is about a 25% chance of them developing pyometra. So the risk is really high. And I know Alan's already seen my video all about pyometra and the facts about that and what that involves. But for those of you that haven't, I'll leave a link up here. I've also talked about spaying, kind of the pros and cons of spaying your female dog, and also when you should think about having your dog spayed. And again, I'll leave that link up here and down in the description below. So, excuse me, so kind of that's really what a tubular ligation is and how it relates to, how it compares to spaying, and what the risks of a pyometra are having had both of those procedures performed. Now, the other question that Alan had was, can mating actually cause a pyometra? And no, there's no risk of mating. That's not going to cause any kind of problem. The potential, infections that can happen if this infection is in your area is something called a transmissible venereal tumor. Now, I've never worked in an area where that's present, but where it is present, that's something that can be transmitted between a dog and a female dog, or the other way around. And that, with those, you tend to get, they appear kind of like tumours on the reproductive organs of our dogs or our bitches. So that's something that can happen, but we're not going to, mating a dog who's had a tubular ligation isn't going to cause pyometra. Mating in general isn't going to cause a pyometra, and there's actually no harm in mating a dog who's had a tubular ligation. There's no way they can get pregnant, because that's the one thing that it does eliminate. It doesn't really do much else. I guess some people will say it does allow the dog to still have the hormones present, and as I discuss in my kind of pros and cons of spaying, it may be that you decide that you don't want to spay your dog for whatever reason, and a tubular ligation would be an option if you really don't want to have to deal with the risk of pregnancy at all. Now, another thing that Alan said is that he's kind of been doing some reading, and a lot of people prefer tubular ligation because it gives their dogs a normal sex life. And, you know, to be honest, kind of, I personally think that's a little bit ridiculous. So I've actually just recorded, and I'm releasing a video in a couple of days, which will have been, this video will be released afterwards, but anyway, releasing a video all about whether you should breed your dog. And, you know, some people then saying, well, they want their dog to experience motherhood, but we've really got to be careful not to anthropomorphize, which is putting our own human feelings onto our dogs and assuming that they need to feel the same thing. Because really, you know, if a dog doesn't have any hormones on board, and that, like, in between seasons or when they're spayed, you know, they really don't miss sex, they don't miss mating. It's just not something that's on their radar. So I don't think that that is a reason to carry out a tubular ligation at all. I think that is putting our own feelings onto our dogs, and that's really not appropriate. So yeah, that's that. excuse me, Alan wanted to, you know, he was kind of thinking, well, he needs to get his dog spayed because his dog's already had a pyometra, and so that does put, you know, him at real, the dog at a really high risk of developing a pyometra again in the future. So that's not a given. You know, she's not definitely going to get a pyometra in future, but if she's had one and it's been medically managed and thankfully successfully managed, you know, the chances are really high that the next season, or maybe the one after that, then she's going to get a pyometra again, and we'll be back to that dangerous situation where she was really sick and there is definitely a chance of death. And I mean, in my opinion, actually, in the vast majority of cases, surgical treatment and ovarian hysterectomy is the definitely the treatment of choice for pyometra where funds allow it. But yeah, that's certainly my opinion. As for other ways that we can prevent a pyometra, really, I don't think there are any. You know, we can give injections that will stop a dog coming onto heat. But really, that, I think that does actually increase the risk of them developing pyometra in the future, especially if they then come onto heat a little bit kind of sooner. They catch us out, if you like, because their heats then can become a little bit irregular. And, you know, if they come on heat again, then I think there's an even higher chance of developing a pyometra. So in my opinion, I would definitely suggest, getting this dog spayed. There is a recovery period. It's 7 to 14 days, something like that. But by and large, if there's no other problems, if there's no other concerns, for an older dog, we should be doing blood tests. They should be on IV fluids, all that kind of thing. As long as there's no other concerns, then spaying your female dog is definitely the most appropriate thing. And yes, there are risks with every surgery. There are risks with every anesthetic. But in my mind, those risks are absolutely tiny compared to the risks of a dog developing pyometra and then needing to be operated on during pyometra. Again, in those cases, the majority of surgeries go without a hitch, but I've certainly known a number of dogs to die from pyometra. So it's not something that's minor and it's not something that's a joke. So I hope that helps, Alan. I hope that helps answer your questions and any concerns that you've had. And I hope that helps everyone else who's maybe considering getting their dog a tubular ligation rather than being spayed. And again, going back to that, in my mind, for an older dog, there's probably very little reason to have a tubular ligation done if you don't want them to have a pregnancy, because a lot of the potential risks of being spayed will not be relevant by the time a dog gets to old age, because they've had the benefit, if you like, of hormones throughout their life. So I don't think there's any going to be any downsides to spaying them compared to having tubular ligation. Again, that's my opinion. You may feel differently. And if you do, I'd love to hear your comments down below and your reasoning behind that. I think if we get a lot of different perspectives, we can help understand, how different people think about things and what their priorities are. So I hope that helps, Alan. And if you've got a question like Alan that you'd like me to answer, then head over to ourpetshealth.com/DrAlexAnswers. I'll leave the link down below. Just submit your question and I'll send you a video just like this one. But until next time, I'm Dr. Alex from Our Pets Health, because they're family.